hindi ho natin mailalayo, if we talk about family, when we do talk about family, we have to look at the husband and the wife first. Amen? Humihina. Humihina. And like what Pastor Louis said, I'll be talking about Ephesians. Alam naman natin siguro po yun, lalo na yung mga lalaki. Diba? Sino po ang mga may asawang lalaki? Mga husbands, taas ang kamay. Naalala po ba natin Ephesians 5:22? Ano ang sabi sa Ephesians 5:22? Ba? Wives, submit to your husband. Period na? Period na ba yun? You see, yan po ang naalala natin mga husbands. Na pag naririnig natin ang mga pastor, mga preacher, mga lecturer na nagtuturo, you know, every time they teach about wives and husband, they use this this chapter, this book. And we're all like, pagka binanggit na Ephesians 5:22, wives, submit to your husband. Oh, kita mo, ha? Sabi ko sa inyo, ha? Di ba? Sabi ko sa'yo, makinig ka sa akin eh. But actually, when God made this instruction, the whole Ephesians 5:22-31, when the Lord was giving this instruction, He was making sure, remember, that God will always bring us to a path so easy in the lightest way that we can follow. Amen? God will always give us an instruction easy and the lightest way to follow that path. If you do not believe, you can check Matthew 28. Verse 30. Anong sabi? For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So whatever God instructs us to do, that is the easiest and the lightest way that a man can go through. But why do we have to go through marital problems since we are talking about family and husbands and wives? Why do we have to go through marital problems? Because we simply do not agree to where God is leading us. And we do the other way around. Amen? Mahina na talaga. Maya-maya, lalakas yan. Maniwala kayo. When the husband and the wife walks down that path that God has created, the easiest and lightest way, they will experience the most loving and peaceful, the richest and fullest life imaginable. When we follow the path that God has created for the husband and wife, then it will be a loving, a joyful, a rich, and fullest experience that we will have. But most of the time, we know better than God. Mga fathers, amen? Di ba? Minsan, mas matalino tayo sa Panginoon eh. Diba? No. Hindi pwede yan. Dapat ito ang gawin natin. Ang daming ano? Kanino? Wife, submit ah. O, ngayon. Diba? But it's true. Nasanay tayo sa ating kultura na tayong mga lalaki because sabi nga nila, padre de familia, Nasanay tayo na, hindi, kung ano sabihin ko, yan ang masusunod. I grew up with a father and who is an authoritarian. Pagka sinabi ng tatay ko, batas, ganun katindi ang salita ng aking ama sa aming bahay. And I grew up. And in the same manner, at times I bring that even now sa aking buhay may asawa. Whatever I say, I have to be followed. Ako ang masusunod. Hindi pwedeng ikaw. Sounds familiar, di ba? Di ba, mga wives? Mabait ang husband niyo, ah. Di ba? Hindi pwedeng babae masusunod. Ako masusunod, lalaki. Ako ang husband. But if we follow the path, we will experience the most joyful, the richest, the fullest, the most loving experience we will have. So we have to define now the duties of a husband and the wife. Dito po tayo mag-uumpisa. Ephesians 5, verse 22. Ang sabi kanina ng mga lalaki, wives, submit to your husband, period. Can you show it up? Ephesians 5, verse 22. Tignan natin kung tama yung mga lalaki. Kung period na nga ba. Period na yata. Wives, submit to your own husbands. Period na ba? Hindi. Meron pa pala. Wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands as you do to the Lord. Yun ang kulang. Kita niyo, meron nag-amen na babae. Lalakas yan mamaya, mga wives. Tayo mga lalaki, yun lang ang naalala natin eh. Wives, submit to your husbands. Oh, tama na. Pastor, tama na, babatuhin kita. Diyan ka lang. Di ba? Yun lang ang naalala. That's why I asked you. Because we all know this verse. Di ba? Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord. Nakalimutan natin yung as to the Lord. We always talk about the first part. Hanggang husbands lang. Nakakalimutan natin yung the most important thing of the verse, as to the Lord. You see, wives, when you submit, husbands, when your wives submit to you, there are three reasons why they do it. You wanna hear it? Ayaw nyo, uwi na tayo. There are three reasons why the wife should submit to the husband. So this is not only, we will try to cover from verse 22 to verse 31, but hopefully we have that much time. But we'll just continue, okay? We'll ask Pastor Lou if we can continue this story. Okay, three reasons why the wife is to be submissive to her husband. This is a lecture or a teaching for the wives to understand. And this is also a teaching for the husband to understand his wife. Amen? Okay. First reason why the wife should be submissive to her husband. To submit is God's will. To submit is God's will. Naalala nyo ba when you were praying for your wife, when you were praying for your husband? Di ba? Kinikilig-kilig pa kayo. Oh, God's will. Oh, yes, God's will. But the problem is when boyfriend, girlfriend, you don't live together. So you don't really get to know the person much. Not like when we live together in one roof. Then you understand. Then you see a character that you've never seen before. Then you see an attitude of your husband that you've never seen before. These things are all revealed when we are living together. When a husband and a wife is living in one roof. And when we prayed for God's will at that time, we would always say, Lord, siya na sana, siya na nga. Lord, wala lang iba. Lord, laging di na ako makatulog. Di na makakain. Di ba? Di ba? Alala niyo pa yun, di ba? Yung sa unat. Di ba? Kasi feeling natin, no, that's God's will. But to submit is God's will too. So kayong mga mas bata, nagpaplanong mag-asawa, you have to understand that when you say, I do to your husband, you will have to submit to that guy. Doon nagkakaproblema eh.
Last na bro.
Doon nagkakaproblema, especially kung ang babae o yung ating magiging wife ay panganay. Diba? Kasi ang mga panganay, medyo aggressive. They are more the go-getters, ika nga. They will always push so that they can get whatever they want. Yan ang mga panganay. Diba? Yung pangalawa, syempre, yung nag-iisang babae sa pamilya who is used to receiving everything. And all of a sudden, when she gets married, she realizes, I have to submit to you. I can ask my brother and he'll give it to me. I can ask my father, he'll give it to me. Di ba? Pero when you were praying God's will, hindi ka makatulog. Meron ka pang pimple sa ilong. Ganun talaga eh. Kahit saan mo tignan, wherever we go. Kayong mga young workers, young people, you will have to understand that you have to submit to someone because that is God's will. And that is part of what you have been praying for na God's will. Now for us who have married already, mga ate, mga tita, we will have to submit to our husbands. You will have to submit to your husband. If you do not, magkakagulo ang inyong pamilya. Why do we submit? Why do you ask me, Brother Joseph, bakit kailangan na mag-submit sa asawa ko? You see, when you submit to your husband, you express your love for Jesus Christ. Because the Lord Jesus Christ has ordained that man be the head of the family. The Lord Jesus Christ said, man will always lead his family. So as you do submit, as a wife, you submit to your husband, you express your love to the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? Wives, do you love the Lord Jesus Christ? Those who love the Lord, raise up your hands. Amen. Then you will submit to your husband.